In the very immediate, however, this is what we came here for. Hi, Kitty. Okay, fair enough. And, nice to meet you, Alvina. Oh, man, where the hell am I? Hey, folks, welcome to 2015, and welcome back to I Played a Thing, Dark Souls, Prepare to Die Edition. I am Un, and, think Salad might have partied a little too hard on New Year's Eve, because, you know, she could swear that last she remembered, some scary misshapen hand was, dragging her through a portal to places unknown, and, you know you've been into the good drugs when you remember that. Well, since we are doing some forest exploration, I've kind of, gussied us up in some explorer-type wear. This is the Wanderer's outfit with the jaunty chapeau we got from Ferris, or whoever stole Ferris's clothes, anyway. And it's good enough for a fast roll, so it should be just fine. And I believe the physical defense is fairly good for light armor, so that should help us out. Now, before we proceed onward into the Sanctuary Garden, I'm going to take a quick look at the Cat Ring. The white cat, Alvina, speaks a human tongue and has lived since the early Age of Fire. Alvina was a trusted friend of Knight Artorias and the Great Wolf Sif. Now, that gives us a few bits of backstory information. First, that Alvina is extremely old and has been around since not long after the time of the lighting of the first flame. And she was also a friend of Artorias, and it also seems that Artorias had a wolf named Sif. I guess that explains why Artorias' symbol among the four knights was the wolf ring. And, also, it's interesting that she is, according to the lore here, a friend of Artorias when she said that Artorias was just a legend and no one could ever actually wander the abyss. Perhaps Alvina knows a bit more than she let on. Alrighty then. It looks like we've only got one way to go, so let's go there. And it leads straight to a fog gate. As you might expect, that indicates boss fight incoming. Yes, the DLC area starts you right off with a boss fight. So, we've got our catalyst, that's good. Do not need the Covetous Serpent Ring here, so let's see, what would be a good choice? I'm thinking Steel Protection would be a good idea. Still fast rolling, very good. Let us switch into burst mode. Power Within, activated. Great Magic Weapon, engaged. Let's do it. Hey, what's up, Manticore? Now, this is an enemy with lots of lightning launching attacks. Fortunately, my Eagle Shield is one of the best for lightning blocks anyway. And as you can see, it can fly around a bit and do some AoE lightning attacks at the water. I thought it had a 3-point attack there, but it has a 4-point attack. Oh, interrupted. This is not a super hard boss, but it's not a joke either. Damn it! Can't seem to get a drink around here. Two. Okay, that's just a 2-hitter. It's been a while since I fought this guy. I didn't do it as part of my test run, so need to do a little relearning. And learning can be a painful process. And we're jerky again. Well, that's alright. Alright, so the Sanctuary Guardian... we can get a little view of the outside world. But the Sanctuary Guardian, as you might guess from the distinctive scorpion tail, does have a tail cut, and it gives you a scorpion tail whip, which is probably the best whip if you're going to use a whip, because if I recall correctly, it inflicts quite a bit of toxic buildup. But if you're using whips in Dark Souls 1, well, you have very strange taste. But yeah, it's probably the best of a bad lot. Let's try this again. Gotta remember to be conscious of that four-hit combo that really caught me off guard and I had a hard time recovering. I can at least get my crappy 1,000 souls back. One, two, just two. Okay, so the headbutts is a two-hitter. Good to remember. Oh, and needless to say, it can toxify you if it hits you with that scorpion tail. Ooh. Don't hit me. It hit me. Definitely hard to get a drink around here. That's better. Shit. When it rears up like that and does that water blast, that's a good time to hit it, but you want to dodge. Don't try to block that. It will break your guard no matter how much stamina and stability you have. At least it doesn't have a whole lot of health now that you can see as I'm actually hitting it. Not to mention the burst damage from my power within and my recently deactivated, Oh, caught me! As I was saying, my recently deactivated great magic weapon. You just attack all day, I don't even care. Oh! Drink, drink, drink. There we go. Okay, power within is down. But we're still hurting it a decent bit, so I don't think I'm going to risk reapplying. And that bull charge of its, yeah, that will definitely knock you down, but it doesn't at least just break your guard and leave you standing the way the rear up water attack does. And one or two more hits ought to be sufficient. Oop! Missed the. Yeah, that went wrong. Hit roll just a second too late. Drink, drink, drink. Very good. Thank you for the opportunity. As I was saying, one or two more hits ought to do it. One, two, three, four, die. Oh, not quite. One, two, three, four, and chop! Ha ha! Alright, Sanctuary Guardian is down, and something unusual about it is the only boss in the game with a soul that cannot be used to make anything. The giant blacksmith can do absolutely nothing with the Guardian soul. All you can do is either consume it for souls or give it to Frampt, and I can't remember which gives you more off the top of my head, so I'll have to check on that and act accordingly. But we can look at it, see if there's any interesting information about it. It has a different colored soul than most of the boss souls, which is interesting. Soul of the White Winged Lion, Sanctuary Watchkeeper, who dreaded the spread of the Abyss. The Guardian exhibited traits of several animals other than lions, suggesting that it was no ordinary beast, but rather closer to the beings known as demons. Well, the thing about it being a demon is not terribly enlightening, but that it dreaded the spread of the Abyss. Well, as I said, Artorias and the Abyss will be fairly central to what happens in the DLC area, so that's not the first we'll be hearing of that. Am I actually going? Yes. There were not stairs on the way back, so we are going the right way. Ulysseal Sanctuary? Didn't Ulysseal, like, collapse centuries ago? That's what Dusk said. She wasn't from our time, and the kingdom of Ulysseal was long gone. So, if this is accurate, and this is a part of an existing Ulysseal, then that can only mean one thing. We've gone back in time to another world where you can be mine. We don't have to worry when you're by my side. There's nothing I don't know. There's nothing to decide. Apart from where we want to go. And it looks like there's only one way we actually can go, which is straight ahead through the archway there. I was just checking around to make sure there was no treasure to recover. And it looks like there was just a humanity. Well, no big deal. Let's see here. Oh, I should probably put my covetous ring back on, just in case there's some opportunities for fat loot drops in the near future. But before we advance, I'm certainly going to want to spark up this bonfire. And we'll do the usual humanity two-step. Very good. Alright. Now, before we move on in any direction, just casting my treasure eye around a little. Anyway, before we move on, there's someone we can talk to. A mushroom person. Hello, mushroom.
Well, look at this one. From what faraway age hast thou come? Thy scent is very human indeed, but not intolerable. Ah, Princess Dusk's savior. Thine aura is precisely as she described. I thank thee deeply for rescuing her highness. But Princess Dusk is here no longer, snatched away by that horrifying primeval human. And so I must ask, couldst thou once more play the savior?
So, this mushroom here is a subject of Princess Dusk's, and it does appear, indeed, that we have been summoned back somehow to ancient Ulysseal. Now, if you don't recall, Dusk was the princess that we rescued from the Golden Crystal Golem, and when we came back, just before entering the DLC area, her summon sign was gone. So it would appear Dusk has gone and gotten herself in trouble again. Well, she's a very nice lady, so we'll do our part.
Thank you. I am Elizabeth, guardian of this sanctuary. Something of a godmother to Princess Dusk. I shall assist thee to my utmost, for I am one with the sorceries of Ulysseal.
Don't know why Salad keeps twitching off to the left. I do have my new controller. I do have my very, very aggressively pink controller, so thank you again, patrons, for helping to fund that. Well, I guess we'll just have to deal with Salad looking off a little to the side at her whim. Let's see what Elizabeth here has for sale. Some standard weapon improvements. And it looks like she has the same kind of magic that Dusk was offering for sale, which stands to reason because she is a fellow spellcaster from Ulysseal. And I want to make sure I have cast light. That is actually going to be very valuable in the future. Does exactly what it sounds like, just illuminates the area, but it has some special uses in the DLC, which we will see when I get that far. Well, we don't really have anything else we need to buy right now, so let's see what else Elizabeth has to say.
Thou shalt see further on. An abyss was begat of the ancient beast, and threatens to swallow the whole of Ulysseal. Knight Artorius came to stop this, but such a hero has nary a murmur of dark. Without doubt he will be swallowed by the abyss, overcome by its utter blackness. Indeed, the abyss may be unstoppable. Still, I have faith that Princess Dusk may be rescued yet.
So from this, we can determine that the primeval human that supposedly spirited Dusk away, has sort of created this outward spreading abyss which threatens to consume all of Ulysseal. And Artorias is a real guy, his legend is confirmed, but Elizabeth doesn't seem too optimistic about his chances. Apparently he's just so pure he'll be easy prey for the abyss. That's not good news.
Thou shalt see further on. An abyss was begat. Night art without indeed still.
Well, that seems to be all that Elizabeth has to contribute for the time being, so we will bid our leave.
May the flames guide thee.
Thanks, Liz. And you may recall that Dusk's own farewell to us was, "May the flames guide thee," so that must be sort of an Ulysseal blessing of some sort. Anyway, despite being dragged in here forcibly, we are not confined to the DLC area in any way. It doesn't have any direct connections to the outside world that you can just walk through, but we can warp as usual. As you can see, the Sanctuary Garden is now on our warp list. But what I'm going to do first off is pay a visit to Oswald the Pardoner and see if I can get some of those infractions cleared from my record. Actually, I take that back. Let's go to Alvina. Because I am definitely interested in seeing what kind of things Alvina has to say to us now that we've gotten on the Forest Hunter shit list. Oh hey, it's Shiva. Hey, buddy. Is that your ninja friend there? Wow, I didn't think they would... Yeah, you already knew I was hostile to you. Yeah, I didn't think these guys were going to show up at all if I was not in good standing with the Covenant. That's a bit of a surprise to me. Well... Shiva didn't quite make it. So now we just have to deal with his bodyguard, which is why we went hostile with these guys in the first place. Now, Shiva is supposed to have a longer speech. Typically, he says more than just, "you poor fool," but it got cut off for some reason. Not sure exactly what happened there. In any case, we can get some humanity from his fallen form. And his iron round shield and Murakumo. The Murakumo being a curved greatsword. And from the ninja, we get the thing that I antagonized these guys for in the first place. The Dark Woodgrain Ring. This is a fun item, but I will demo it in just a bit.
Oh, it is thee. Thine kinsmen are betrayed by thee. This doth bode most badly. No rest will ease thy rotten soul whilst there is one clansman living. Forever tormented thou shalt be by our very howls. Hellish villain, thou hast used us most foully, thine only family. For thee, no mercy shall be shown.
Haters gonna hate. Yeah, Alvina, I think I liked you better when you were a Nyan Cat. Oh well. The only thing we really came here for was to meet back up with Shiva. And, well, you know what? Just in case I need to be on good terms with the Forest Hunters lately, I think I'll go absolve my sin anyway, just because I can show that anyway. You know, you haven't seen me buy an indulgence from Oswald, so I'm gonna go do that anyway. Hey, Ozfest! What's the going rate for a spiritual enema these days?
Good time. Laudable is thy dedication to sin.
Yeah, pretty dear. The cost for an absolution, I don't believe it has anything to do with your level of sin. I believe it is just flatly based on your soul level, and since we've been doing quite a bit of leveling up, this is, not a cheap undertaking. But hey, what price purity, huh? Yep, that whole, kinsman murdering thing? Never happened.
Or is he not too drenched in sin?
Well, Petrus did kind of abandon the priestess he was chosen to protect, so I guess there is that. Anything else? No, he's just fixated on Petrus. While we're here, I forget what all you had to sell. Oh, why not? We'll pick up a Book of the Guilty while we're in town. Karmic Justice we don't really need. Velka's Talisman is actually kind of interesting. I don't remember if I talked about it before, but it's a talisman that works on intelligence rather than faith. So, if you have a character with lots of intelligence and you just want to be able to cast a few miracles, it's not as good as a dedicated faith talisman with a high faith character. But if you've got lots of intelligence and no faith, it's better than most. Okay, we don't need any of these rings.
If thou committest a crime, bring myself back here. There is no misdoing that I cannot undo.
Thanks, Ozzy. Alright, back to good old Ulysseal. Oh, two things at this point I should draw attention to. First is, if we go back to the sanctuary at this point, or rather to the sanctuary garden water pool where we had the boss fight, now in that place there will be 3 sanctuary guardians. So that's a nice challenge fight if you wish. Personally, I do not relish the idea of fighting 3 of those at once, so I'm gonna pass. Let's see, okay, we got that out. Let me put my bow on just to be on the safe side. Still fast rolling, good. Oh, speaking of fast rolling, I should really demo that ring. Let's see, dark wood grain, there we are. This special ring, crafted in an eastern land, is made of gold, but with a wood grain crest on its surface. Agents of subterfuge in this faraway land are particularly fond of the dark wood grain, which greatly alters its wearer's rolling action. They're not kidding. If you are at fast rolling weight and wearing the dark wood grain ring, your fast roll becomes a flip. Now, the fast roll, or not the fast roll, the ninja flip is not appreciably faster than the fast roll, if indeed it is faster at all. I'm not 100% sure there. But one thing that is notable is that it has more iframes. So the timing for rolling through attacks is not as tight, which is very useful. This item used to be super broken. In the original release of Dark Souls, you could wear it and ninja flip at any weight. Like, you could be wearing a full set of hovel armor, have your equip weight almost to the maximum, and you would get the ninja flip. However, it was nerfed in future patches, so that you had to have fast roll weight in order to get the ninja flip. Because, yeah, really, being able to do a fast, high iframe roll at any equip weight, you can see how that was just a little too good to live. But you may rest assured that people had fun with it back in the day. Anyway, we are now moving on to the Royal Wood. God, I hate the Royal Wood. This part tends to kill me a lot, so we may be editing out a bunch of deaths here. If it gets too bad, what I'll probably end up doing is just running for my life and just trying to sprint through, probably weeping all the way. Because the Royal Wood is just chock-a-fucking-block with these scarecrow enemies, which are individually not too bad, but, you know, if you get a bunch of them up in your shit, just like any enemy, they can become a problem. Not too much HP, and they don't hurt that bad, but again, potentially dangerous in numbers. Well, a little more antitoxin is always nice to have, I suppose. Anyway, more of a concern than the scarecrow dudes are the guardians. The guardians are big stone motherfuckers who do big, big damage. And while not nearly as populous as the scarecrows, there are more than enough of them to make your life really unpleasant. And I don't really remember my way around here too well, so that's not going to help matters. What is kind of interesting, though, is that the Royal Wood here shares a layout with Darkroot. So it would appear that Darkroot Garden is the location of what once was Ulysseal's Royal Woods. So things do change with time. That is a guardian there. I'm going to try and attract his attention without getting everything else in the area aggroed at me. Nope, it looks like it did attract the attention of the scarecrow as well. But at least I'm making them come to me, which is not always a terrible thing. These fuckers always give me fits. They hit really hard, and they can hit you again with that dirt-spraying attack when they lift up their axe. And as you can see, they're not easy to hurt either. Very tough. Not very fast, at least. But just the fact that they hurt so damn bad, and that they can take such a beating, just means they can really brick wall you. And they'll chase you a while, too. See, look how much stamina that lift of the axe out of the ground did. Bananas. So yeah, I'm not really going to be fighting too many of these guys when I can help it. But if memory serves, they'll follow you. They will keep after you. I'm just kind of taking this left route right now because I don't really know where I'm going. Whether this is a wise direction to travel, I could not tell you. But I'll get somewhere eventually. Oh hey, scarecrows. Just trying to hit that guy over there while I could. I like their pitchforking attack where it just looks like they're pitching hay. Hey you, who said you could leave? No leaving. Being able to two-shot them is certainly a plus, though. They can drop their pitchfork, that is a valid weapon that you can use, but it's not a particularly exciting weapon, so, you know, I'm not that worried about whether I get one or not. If memory serves, it is classified as a spear, which means at least you can attack enemies from behind your shield with it. But I do not think it is a very good spear. Certainly it is no match for the winged spear. Oh, that was satisfying, although then I got ganked. But we'll take the little victories where we can find them. Oh, hi. It's like they can carry all three kinds of moss. I see a guardian over there. I see no reason to attract his attention. And I think I have run into a dead end, maybe? Yes, that appears to be the case. But maybe I'm gonna have to go through that guardian after all. Well, if that's how it's gotta be, then that's how it's gotta be. Let's see if I can get the Scarecrow after me on his lonesome first. No need to take on a Guardian and a Scarecrow if it's not required of me. And it looks like the Guardian was not interested in that arrow hitting his buddy, so... Oops, no, he was. And just so he doesn't follow me across half the map, I'm gonna go ahead and take him down, as slow as that is. Oh, you know what I should have done? I should have attuned Great Pyromancy. Why do I keep calling it that? I mean, Great Combustion. That probably would have helped. Oh, God! Yeah, these guys look like they'd be more than happy to two-shot me if I gave them a chance. At least with that one big swing of theirs. Oh, shit! Mind the follow-up swing. No, you may not. I think if you're not standing close to them when they pull the axe out of the ground, they don't do that big grunty dirt clod attack. That's just if they think they have a good chance to follow up at you. Die, die, die. Thank you. Don't think they can drop anything of interest, although I could be wrong on that. Couldn't swear to it. Are you dead or just sleeping? No, you are actually dead. Okay. Well, what I'm gonna do is I'm going to try a more rightward path this time. What is that over there? Is that a guardian? Or is that a scarecrow? Can't tell, but I'm gonna take the opportunity to get him out of the way so I don't have to deal with him later. Yeah, but he's so far away you can't even tell what shot him. That is one downside of the Black Bow of Ferris. Sometimes if you're really far away and you shoot something to gain their attention, they won't even know what the fuck. Yeah, just for area-solving purposes, let's try and follow the right path here. Okay, you're actually dead, that's good. Dead guardians are my favorite guardians. Oh, and having nothing to do with what I'm dealing with at the moment, but I think I did figure out why GTF and I were unable to co-op back when we tried for, An Orlando. I have recently learned that, in the post-Games for Windows Live patch of Dark Souls for PC, and I guess that's some vestiges of the Kingdom of Lucille, but getting back to what I was saying, to co-op with someone in the Steam Online version of the PC Dark Souls, you have to be set to the same Steam download location. We probably were not, because I didn't know that, and I don't think GTF did either. So I think that is where we went awry. There's a Guardian there. They actually have a pretty good aggro radius, so I think if I try to proceed much further, I'll get his attention anyway. So let's get it now when we know it's coming. They are not swift, so at least they will not, like, charge up in my shit. Yeah, see there, he didn't bother to do the big dirt blast because I was not close to him when he pulled his axe out. You guys know how bad I am at roll dodging, so it just shows that these guys are relatively easy to roll dodge, which is good because they take off so much of my stamina when I block their shit. Yeah, I remember your follow-up swing this time. And that time. And there will be no third time. Oh, he did drop something. What would this be then? Ah, Twinkling Titanite. Something we can purchase, but getting it for free is always better. Now this, if I'm not mistaken, is where a shortcut will be. Yes. Eventually, this elevator is in its down position. Eventually, we will activate it so we can take it up and down to the end of the Royal Wood. I really wish it were active now, but no such luck. We can, however, get a piece of the Guardian set, which is heavy armor. Very heavy armor that we will not be using, but let's take a look at it. Gauntlets of the Stone Knights, Guardians of the Forest Sanctuary. The Stone Knights are golems animated by magic, and their enchanted gauntlets are oppressively heavy. Heavy as they are, if you are going a very tanky heavy armor route, they are quality armor. Excellent physical defense, if I recall correctly. Alright, let's continue on our way. I think I'm looking for a bridge across this gorge, ultimately. Oh, Mr. Scarecrow, if you only had a brain. But you have a pointy thing, and that's all you really need, I suppose. I don't want this guardian following me halfway across the map, so let's just be done with him. Let's get ambushed by a scarecrow. That's embarrassing. Gotta get him out of the way. Haha, in-battle looting. The Guardian swings are slow, which is one of your saving graces in dealing with them. Everything they do is pretty slow. But it hurts. Give myself a moment for stamina recovery there. Very good. Oh, that charging attack, that don't feel good. Well, one good bit of news with these guys, being as slow and ponderous as they are, it's usually not that hard to get your chugs in if you need one. And I will need one. Again. Die, die, die! Okay, gotta watch that Estus consumption. Beep. Okay, I don't think I've got the attention of those guys over there, which is a good thing. We'll just keep walking in this direction for now. Gotta find the right way eventually. I see a bridge. Is that the bridge I want? I think it might be the bridge I want. Nothing down here waiting to gank me. Nothing down here waiting to gank me. Okay, safe so far. Looking... Oh dear God! Where did you come from? Yeah, that's right. You just keep walking. Flying. Whatever it is you do. Thank you for not staying. Yeah, I think there are guardians patrolling on the cliff above me. I'm hearing faint footsteps. Don't know if you folks can hear them on the YouTubes, but... Oh, yeah. Got his attention. I have to be careful because I don't really have room to strafe here. Yeah, some of the guardians do patrol around. They just kind of wander until they either catch sight of you or repeat their patrol path. And the ones that patrol, they seem to have an unusually high aggro radius. Oh god, he's brought a friend. That's not the most gorgeous situation, and you know what? I think I'm just going to go now. Crystal Lizard. Well, that went all wrong. Yeah, I don't want none of these two. I don't think there's a hell of a lot to loot around here, so I think at this point I'm just gonna let these guys get back to their business. Oh yeah, some of the, a few, I think, of the scarecrows do have sort of pruning shears that they will come after you with. Not really any more dangerous than the pitchfork. Actually, probably less so. Although they can inflict bleed on you, which I don't think the pitchforks can. I think the guardian just fell to their death because I just got all kind of money for no good reason. Okay, I'm going to get a chance to take a drink here, and then I'm going to... Ow. See if I can clear these guys out. Die the lot of ya. Oh man, I'm dying. I'm dying. Get a drink. No. Oh, hallelujah. That got really ugly for a moment. And all for a gold coin. Not really worth risking your life for framp food. Huh. That got messy. This is the sort of thing that makes me not the world's biggest fan of the Royal Wood. But we do get a lovely view of the Kingdom of Ulysseal from this vantage point. And yeah, I'm out of the good stuff, and so I think I'm going to have to just be very careful not to take more damage. But, just to be on the safe side, I'll put some humanity in my quick access there, just so I can emergency heal if I'm starting to get close. Don't want to die at the very last possible moment. Oh man, there are just hella guardians here. You know, I'm pretty much looking like I have to pass them, so let's first at least try to sneak the scarecrow out here. Fuck, I just aggroed the whole city. Alright. Operation Flee in Terror commence. Oh, gee, mini Christmas. Got myself back to the little stone bridge where the fuck-off gigantic dragon showed up out of nowhere and thankfully left. He's not here again now. I see a treasure on the overhang there, so, let me see if I can yoink that out from under the noses of the guardians. I'm not gonna spend too much time fighting them this time, because really, why bother? Damn crystal lizard. You know, nothing's chasing me right now, so I'm gonna do the reload dance and see if I can get that lizard taken care of. There we go. Just some twinkling. That's a pretty unexciting haul. But what can you do? Okay, not too much guardian attention on me right now. That's a positive. Always a positive. Oh, and I forgot to look for that treasure that I said I was going to. Well, you know what? It's not worth attracting more guardian attention over. So I'm just going to keep pressing forward. Oh, hey, I see my soul pile. That was not a small soul pile, so it would be nice to recover that if I can. So let's bait out these guys and hope they don't bring too much company with them. Scarecrows are not that bad, but you do have to remember, they do have reach. You had a crack at me from a little further than I quite anticipated. Oh yeah, I remember this. There was a hell of a party over here. Ow! Jerk. I am not shrubbery. Do not need trimming. My leafy greens are not for harvesting. Yeah, that appears to be the shtick with the gardening shears guys. They just have a bleed build up on their weapons, which the pitchfork guys do not. No ambushes, no whammies. I got my souls! I'm happy, because that's a decent-sized soul pile. I wanted that back. Alright, you know what? I want to make this just a tiny bit safer, so it's time to put the steel protection on. There we are. And if I advance here, I am going to get the attention of World Plus Dog. So let's top up completely. You've got the Estus to spare. I'm gonna try and get their attention and then just haul ass on through. Hopefully this time without getting stabbed in the back and dying in a single hit. Because that was embarrassing. Die, die. No reason we can't get the scarecrows out of the way. They're easy to kill. Two guardians, one cup is not my idea of fun. So these guys, I'm going to let them continue living because I am a gracious soul that way. Aren't I nice? That is a lizard. I want it dead. Oh, come on, die. There we go. More twinkling and a blue chunk. I am unexcited by this. Where the fuck was that going? Hey, friend. I don't want to fight. I see something behind this building. Let's see if we can retrieve that. Soul item. Not that brilliant, but I'll take it. Please don't have cut me off. Thank you for not having cut me off. Thank you for not killing me outright. And thank you for letting me drink. Ugh. Bye! Now then. I believe this is the shortcut elevator that I can activate. No, this is a different shortcut entirely. Alright, that is gonna be job number one, is finding that shortcut elevator, because my god, I don't want to do the Royal Wood again. I know it's around here. This looks like an illusory wall, but it's just part of the architecture. This is where I just was for that other shortcut. Yes, that's not gonna help me right now. This kind of leads down into the valley here. That's not where I want to be. Where the hell is it? Well, maybe it's over here. Yeah, there's a dude over there that I can talk to, but again, I am really prioritizing activating that shortcut, because God, I need that. Okay, I see a little portal here, so I am going to assume that is it. Please be it. Yes, because this is where I found those Guardian Gauntlets. Oh, this is wonderful. Now we have an easy path back down here to the new friend we will be meeting momentarily. Hello, new friend. I like that outfit.
Let me guess. Snatched by a shadowy limb and dragged off to the past.
How'd you know?
Yes, of course. Exactly what happened to me. We are both strangers in this strange land. But at least now there are two of us.
That's true. Interesting. It seems we've got a fellow time traveler here. I hear dogs. Why do I hear dogs? I think they're down in the gorge. Not a problem right now.
Did you happen across Knight Artorias, the legendary abyss walker from the old tales? Well, if you haven't, it's just as well. He's a colorless sort, if you ask me.
No, we haven't met Artorias. Is he in the neighborhood? Even if he's kind of a bore, I should probably track him down. It's not every day you get to meet a legend.
So, what did that giant mushroom make you do? Not that I care. It's none of my business.
Well, she does want us to rescue Princess Dusk, but, you know, I wouldn't say she's making us do that. She asked fairly nicely, and it's not like we haven't rescued Dusk before.
I've little to talk about, really. Oh, you know me. What do I know?
Well, I guess that's it. What have you got here? Pretty eclectic set of supplies. That's nice. Looks like you got some ammo, too. Nothing we need right now, but good to know we've got a source of supplies here if we need it. This gentleman, by the way, is Marvelous Chester. And one thing to keep in mind about Marvelous Chester, he's your only source of supplies around here, but he is expensive. I think he sells his stuff for about twice the price of what most merchants do.
So long.
Oh, actually, I should try the usual thing with talking to a merchant and seeing if buying anything will loosen his tongue at all.
Oh, still alive, are you? Think of anything that you might need?
Well, we're pretty good on most of this stuff, but I suppose we could always use a few more arrows. Shame you don't have the poison kind, but we'll take some regulars. I guess that's it.
So long.
Alright, well, I guess that's really about as much time as we need to spend right now. I'm just glad to have made it through the Royal Wood without too many attempts. So, next time, we will continue our exploration of ancient Ulysseal, and I think we've got a boss fight in our very near future. So, I hope you're enjoying your 2015 so far. It has been a great pleasure, as always. This is Un, for Marvelous Chester and Salad, signing off. Catch you later. Along with our new year, we have a new month, which means a refresh of our supporter credits. Now, I'm still kind of getting used to the whole Patreon thing, so bits of it have me a little bit confused. Like, some of you folks had your contributions at a certain level, but you had apparently selected a lower reward level, and I'm not sure entirely how that works, so I just put you where it looked like you wanted to be. If any of this is wrong, and you're not where you expect to be, please let me know, and I will look into getting that corrected. But for now, I would like to say thanks to everyone who contributed, including Justin Carpenter, Noden, Zangamarth, our anonymous benefactor, Sanguine Games, Frank Greasy, Joseph Coco, John Madigan, Misha Van Doren, and Johnny Millennium. As always, if I have mispronounced anything, please make sure you let me know, and I will get that right next time. And also, those of you in the top tier, if you have any shout-outs or plugs you would like me to make for a channel or any project that you're doing or whatever, I will be more than glad to mention it, so again, just let me know. Thank you all, and I'll see you soon.